what? Why is my mixer got that much rubble in it? Right, look at this now, Sean. There'll be Libras or whatever watching this now, yeah. And they'll be sickened by this. Oh, help me out, yeah?
Careful with all the wire, that.
Careful. Right, get a mixer on. Give that a bit of a wash out first, this water, yeah? Unbelievable. Anyway, so we're just gonna be here now for today. I'll show you what we do later on. Right, so we're up on the Alley Tower on the internal wall, the 6-inch wall, and I'll just show you how the roof is going. So you got a truss going from wall plate there, and from wall plate there. And this is going to have like a little gable end there. You see them all down there already. And this is going to be a cut roof. So this roof's going to be higher. There's going to be two valleys in it. Now I need to build this wall up to take the other padstone to take the ridge beam. So we've got this padstone in for the purling. However, the roof, the trusses, there's a separate truss to go in on this internal wall, and it's basically going in hanger, yeah. Now what I have to do is get the bottom of the hanger level with the top of the wall plate. Now how I've done that is I put a string line off the wall plate to wall plate, yeah, so that's effectively my wall plate height there, yeah? And I've already measured down, so that is the cut. And what we've got here now is, see how that is, I don't know if you can see the rope. Yeah, it's there, isn't it? So if I just go along now, putting this cut 6-inch along here, and then after that, I need to mark out where these go. So there is a drawing for the truss. So I'll have to measure from one end, I'll mark the wall where these go, and then bed them in, and then run my blocks on top. Now I have asked if the joiners could put a batten on the wall. Righty, righty, so I've done that course, and on the drawing here it shows from the wall, let's turn it round, but it's actually the opposite way, yeah. So this is my wall here, and what I've got is 2068 up until the last truss on the wall plate, yeah, and then it's these then that start the hangers, so that's my start point really. So 2068, what I've done is measured from that wall to there, 2068, put that brick on the edge there so I can measure off, and then he said these are 400 centres, so forget your centre, I know that's the edge, so I'm going 400 from that edge to there, bang on 400, and so on. So hook that into there now, it's 400, so maybe just a little bit less, 400, that's too much, 1 mil out, okay, 400. Okay, so I'll just put a block on that now, and I'll just go boom boom boom, put a block on that. The reason why this one's different to this one is because you can see that the wall's actually not going any higher than this, so they put these are like extra ones because I don't know, there's like an angle thing on it. It's because there's not that much weight on it, so they beef up the hanger. So yeah, there you have it. But you see how I've done it now. I've gone to the drawing that I've been told. There you go. This is what I figured out, okay? Now, see them cuts up there? So I've done it with my little angle finder here. If I don't put them in now, I'm trying to have a little wrap here. if I don't put them in now, I gotta put them in when all that wood, the roof, and that will be Ninja Warrior stroke Spider-Man trying to lay 6-inch solids cuts. Beautiful, look at this. Come on. Oh. Right, so we are Padstone height, I think. So what I'm gonna do is cut a little bit off the padstone. So what I've got there is 560 or 565, yeah. So I've done the maths here, but I'll just show you. So I've 560, yeah? And I know that the wall plate and steel is 380. So 0, 0. Getting that, sorry, that one in it, it's a 4. That becomes 16. 16 minus 8 equals 8. 180 minus 10 mil cut. 170. 170 cut, please, Sean. Do you want a maths lesson up here? Do you want a maths lesson up here?
Hi, mate. So, padstone's in, yeah. Left a little pocket there out. I've done all the cuts ready because it's going to be too awkward otherwise. Can you see the string line there? String lines with a wall plate.
So we've had some bricks this morning, and this is what we've been given. The shit. The leftover fucking shit. Sorry for swearing, but you know, as a facing brick specialist, when I get shit, that's how much I dislike having rubbish stuff. Anyway. Keeps on giving me. Get back in there, yeah. Sparky pipe, cable. Joe and Craig have been on this. Craig's on the other side. Now, Colonel Cobble. Trench blocks are shocking. Colonel Cobble. Hello there. So, you know, with having any sort of successful channel program, they have to have opening credits or intro. Now, obviously the name of the channel, the program's called Hot Trowel, so I've got a blowtorch in the van there that needs to be off-hired before I become broke. So what I'm thinking of doing is burning my trowel so it's really hot, and then obviously laying with it so it'll be like. So I'd like to do that, and also I'll probably do it today actually, because I'm on bricks. I don't want to do it with blocks, it just takes it off, you know. I was waiting for bricks to do it. It takes, like, you know, the block work isn't exciting, let's be real. I mean, block work. So I've got a clip of clips. There's one of me going down some stairs in a bath. Got one of me running through a wall, plasterboard wall. I did have one before where there was like 20 tons of sand delivered, and we were daring each other to jump off the top of the scaffolding onto the sand. Now I don't know if that'd gone down well in future, especially if some people are wanting to award me some work. So, but that was years ago. So I've obviously grown up a lot since then. So I don't know. Bit boring, just laying bricks. So we want to have a bit of fun, don't we? You know, that's what life's all about. Having fun, paying bills, and having some more fun. What happened there? Sorry, what happened there? Got my coffee on there from the squalier. Just gonna get my camera out anyway. Close the door, the thing's falling on the floor. Bang! What a shot. Tried to save it with my foot. What's happened? Burnt my ankle with coffee. How the hell did that happen? Anyway. Look at that. Oh my god. Oh. And then just something special. Turkey, egg, cheese, mayo, lettuce, tomato. Bap. Life's good, man. Life's good. Imagine paying someone, yeah? Decent bloody money, yeah, to put mortar in a bucket and to put bricks load you out, only to have to do it yourself. Where is he now? Skiving. Loaded all out myself. So here's the setup. Built a bit of a corner yesterday, there and there, the other side as well, but like I said before, it was Colonel Corbel yesterday, so I couldn't go high. I could only come out a little bit, let it go off, otherwise the wall would want to just come out. So, sweaty Betty. Hey, been to the gym this morning? Oh yes. Anyway, tell you a little tip, right? If you're doing this sort of thing and the board looks like it's going to snap, just put like a bit of a scaffold clip thing there, and it just takes the belly out of it. What is this flipping rubbish? Also, whilst the camera's out, I've got to put it away. Wednesday, glove update. Imagine just saying that, glove update. So, the Wonder Grip, yeah? Okay, now, lay bricks yesterday. Daisy. Wednesday, isn't it? Monday, would it be Monday? Oh yeah, 6-inch blocks. Friday, obviously footing. Yeah, so we're talking Friday, Monday, Tuesday. I did half day Thursday. And literally like, I wouldn't say like new, but no, there's only just a little hole there. But, you know, still going strong, and usually by 3 days you'd see something going on the glove, but no, nothing. So far so good, and trust me, I'm not going easy on these bad boys. Don't like them. Look who came crawling back. Hey, how long has it been since we were on the line together? Where were we on the line together last? We weren't on that house, were we? Because obviously I smashed you and Craig that day.
Oh, yeah.
And then, when was it last? We've been working in Llanonna. When was that, last week?
Yeah.
So Joe and me, my apprentice, he's so good.
Lunchtime menu is plain large pork. Oh yes. It looks tiny there, isn't it? There we go, tiny little chicken. It's not large, is it? What's that? What's that? 3-4 inches. It's not a large chicken, is it? The size of that boy. Second one, right. I don't know, I think I'm defeated here. Gonna ask the forklift now if he can pick me up to take me to the job.
Good morning, good afternoon, whatever the hell it is. Tell me the current situation. Oi, Bodger. Oi, Badger. Got me smash. Some of you might not remember that. Bodger and Badger. Bit of bodgery and badgery going on over here. So basically, these lintels. We've only put them in once. The forklift driver gives some lintels to put in. Put them in, cut pockets, put them in. Join us, says the wrong ones, so we have to replace them again.
Right then.
After doing the last one, so like you can carry on going back. No, you carry on going back.
Thank you.
Joe, turn that radio down, we'll be copyright claim on my YouTube channel again. Bloody Justin Bieber every time. Not as if we've listened to him either. Why we listen to Justin Bieber for?
I don't know,
your preference. For, yeah, just put his phone in his pocket. So, Thursday, and we're on the back now. Look at that. Look at that. That's what we did yesterday. Can't see it properly, it's still a bit dark in here. Anything to report? Nothing. However, should say that there's some stuff going on, like well behind the scenes, about work in the local area, specifically Anglesey, where we are. Oh, ring doorbell just going, who's this? Oh, yes. Oh, the kids home from school. I love you, cheeky monkey.
What time are you going to be out?
Smile. Give us a smile.
What time are you going to be out?
What's that? Sean, what time are we finishing work today?
Early.
Early, Sean says. Where's Bobby?
So what time are you going to be out?
I don't know what time it is now. What time is it now?
Four.
Oh, give me a quarter of an hour here and I'll be going home. So I'll be home maybe quarter to five.
Come and see that. Come and see that.
Hello? Hello? Yeah. I'm looking at you. And also, everyone on YouTube will be looking at you. Ah, oh, I love that. A school photo. Oh, let me see the one of Zoe. Oh, that's a brilliant photo. He's smiling. How mad is this? I'm looking through a camera. Through a camera.
How mad is this, huh?
Yeah.
I've been cleaning your skids from Abbey.
Oh, yeah, you've done me dirty there. Yeah, I'm going to be doing character. Oh my god, did he? Bobby says bye, skidhead. Oh my god. Oh god. So, bye, skidhead. Yeah, time to go now, isn't it? Anyway, what's happening is, and basically, I had a phone call about a year ago off a. Shall I name the company? Yeah, Williams Homes, off the QS, some woman, Katrina, something like that names. She said to me, oh, we've got 30 new builds going up in Pentraeth on the island. And then after that, we've got 50 new houses in Valley. Oh, bloody hell, 80 houses. Yeah, I'm interested. You know, it's what we do. The timber frame. Timber frame, okay. Okay, I'll give you my email address, blah blah blah, so I can look at them, give you a price, blah blah blah. An hour later, get a phone call. Oh, I've just spoken to the senior QS. There is no brick and block on site. Sorry, no brick and block on site. No, we're doing like a raft foundation, and then we're putting timber frame up, and we're cladding it and plastering the cladding, the cement board or whatever. Bloody hell. So you're telling me there's 80 odd houses there with no brick and block, no bricky on site? No, yes, sorry for the phone call, thanks for nothing. So, anyway, I was a bit annoyed about that, you know. Hopefully it wouldn't be a current trend. And there is site down the road. So this site here is timber frame, which again, 50% of the work has gone to timber people, whatever. Now, there's a site down the road in Pentraeth, another site, and there's 20 odd houses going there apparently. Hey, are you looking for bricklayers? Oh no, we don't need bricklayers on the site. It's in with planning and design at the minute. They're trying to do a raft foundation and cement board and plaster. Oh, okay, so another 20 houses there. Oh, okay. Right, I'm not having this. Phoned up the councillor, Carwyn Jones. Listen, I spoke to him before about this, which these council people that approve the planning, they don't know the actual ins and outs of these cheap shed houses things. So phoned him and told him, I told him before when I seen him face to face, that I wasn't happy about this. You know, how long is it until there's a, you know, this trend becomes the norm? Timber frame is now the norm, which, do I rate them? No. Do you live in a timber frame house? No. At least there's brick and block on the outside. So he wants me to have a meeting now with, was he an MP? Rhun ap Iorwerth or something like that. So he wants me to do some background stats or whatever. So I've spoken to the building inspector before about this, not recently, but I have recently now, saying that he was saying these timber frame now, they're rubbish. He was the building inspector on these 80 houses that I missed out on. They're saying they're absolutely rubbish, but he can't say that on record, he said, because they employ him to as a building inspector. Okay, so you can't go on paper, you know, do a statement to me saying that these houses are rubbish, but technically they pass the regs. However, the lifespan of these houses are, it's like buy now, pay later. 6 mil is the render that's on it, 6 mil. Now, you know, and these are all social housing, so the type of people, nothing against the type of people that's there, but you just know that they're not paying for the houses themselves. Maybe, I don't know what the crack is, but they're not going to look after them. The kids' bikes are going to be, handlebars going to be going through it, wheelie bins will easily crack that. And once the water goes in there, bam, game over. So, how long will they last? Not as long as a brick and block traditional build. Nowhere near. So they'll get these houses and they'll just inherit problems in 20 years. But anyway, the building inspector also told me that DU Construction have got 15-20 houses on the island as well, and the council, or these social housing people, but they're muffling in about 8 minutes, have basically, these contractors get more money off social housing if they don't use brick and block.
Makes sense, does it?
So obviously from their point of view, they're going to make more money anyway, because there's less, they're basically cheaper houses to build, so they're saving money there. But they also get an extra bit of money if they use newer building methods. Okay, so you know, obviously stick to what you know, isn't it? Brick and block, safe as houses, isn't it? So we've got, you know, within a year now, not just my gang, the college, the apprentices, no one's going to be coming through the college if this is, you know. How many people are building new houses themselves now? It's mostly social housing. So it's what, best part of 120 houses there on the island with no bricklayers, and they're going to get thrown up, whatever. How many bricklayers would that have employed? Trained young lads, kept them off the streets, maybe some sort of future for them. So anyway, that's going on in the background. Trying to get the college on board. I don't know why I'm doing it out of my own back, really. But it's just, it's like, I don't know, it just kind of get, not as it get me down, but I'm just thinking about it a lot, like how it's like okay to build houses now with no brick and block. It's not okay, is it? I mean, it just sounds horrible. I'll tell you a good example of this, right? Look at this level here. Because these timber frames that go up, okay, you think, oh yeah, wood should be straight. Have a look at this now, okay? These timber frame houses that they put on, and they just put, I spoke to the building inspector about this, they're all over the shop. Within a level, they can be out 5 to 10 mil, okay? Let alone being like, you know, a wave. So what we got here, okay? See this here now? Okay, look at that. You can even see off the scaffold board there, look. Yeah, these timber frame, they're absolutely all over the shop. And what they do, they just put a board on that now and plaster it. And I told the building inspector, and he says, the tolerances, if they're within the tolerant, they're passed. However, he did say that when you look down these walls and they're like this, and the wood that goes on, where if it's wet, the weight of the roof on there, heat, cold, hot, cold, they expand, they contract, things are going to start cracking. Once they crack, water penetrates, bang. Don't like it. That's it, off on this site. It's Friday, what, 12 o'clock? Look at these bosses in here. There you are. So, I'm going off to another job. Bed the wall, please.
Hey, I want a cut.
Cut?
Cut.
Right, so there we have it in Llanfonna. It's ready for roof. Just came back just to bed this wall plate here. I'm taking these two patterns down. Hopefully I should stay up with the
with the wind. Dicey to be honest with you, but they are. Yep. Right.
Next week, I'm on one. On Monday, I'm doing two jobs. And I've got conservatory base in Llanfairpwll to go back to, and back in Llangefni. So it's at Caravan Park, Bumaris, Monday, Tuesday back on site, Wednesday, PG, Thursday, Friday, and then the week after that we're starting another job, meant to be. So yep, catch you on the next one.